This dramatic painting depicts a tragic event that became a huge public embarrassment for the French monarchy. Let's find out why. Hi everyone and welcome back to Exploring Art with Alessandro. This is the third episode of the Romanticism series and today I want to talk about a painting that was inspired by a real tragedy, The Raft of the Medusa by Théodore Géricault. What I'm going to say is based on true events and I want to anticipate they are kind of shocking. However, we are going to appreciate more the great job of the painter and the impact he had. So time to hide my face and I suggest you to watch this video full screen. Enjoy! The Raft of the Medusa is an oil painting of 1818-1819 completed by the artist when he was 27. It's a huge painting, 491 by 716 centimeters or 16 by 23 feet, that depicts a moment from the aftermath of the wreck of the French naval frigate Meduse, which ran aground off the coast of today's Mauritania on 2nd July 1816. Let me tell you very fast the story behind the event. The captain of the frigate, in an effort to make good time, on July 2nd ran aground on a sandbank off the West African coast. Efforts to free the ship failed, so on July 5th the passengers and crew started an attempt to travel the 100 kilometers, or 60 miles, to the African coast in the frigate's 6 boats. However, the Meduse was carrying 400 people and there was space for only about 250 of them in the boats. So at least 146 men and one woman took place onto a really unsafe raft that already partially submerged once it was loaded. The captain and crew aboard the other boats intended to tow the raft, but after only a few miles, the raft was turned loose. After 13 days without food and water, the raft was rescued by the Argus by chance, and by that time, only 15 men were still alive. In the attempt of surviving, the men were killing each other, had thrown themselves into the sea, some died of starvation, but some opted for cannibalism. The event became an international scandal and Géricault cleverly chose to depict this event to launch his career. So he painted this tragic scene that can be divided into two sections, the lower one, where we can see death and hopelessness, and the upper one with the survivors who are waving at something. Géricault in fact depicted the moment when the Argus is visible, well, barely visible, on the horizon and she will rescue them. This emotional contrast is amplified also thanks to the chiaroscuro effects that make the scene even more dramatic, showing the great realism that Géricault has been able to reach. He did it painting carefully every single detail, from the faces to the muscles, but also the clothes and of course the environment. Even if the raft fills most of the painting, in fact, and the double pyramid structure helps to suggest this idea, the environment is fundamental. In Romanticism, nature was really important, and here this importance is evident because the warm sunset is in contrast with the immense cloudy sky and the scary wavy ocean that in one moment could crush the raft and the survivors. As I said in the first episode, these are the foundations of Romanticism, the role of the man and his emotions amplified by the power of the nature, in one word, sublime. You can imagine the impact this painting had back then. The event was really popular, but just on words. Géricault undertook extensive research, he interviewed two of the survivors, and he visited hospitals and morgues to be more accurate. As a result, he put the viewers in front of a picture, and that inspired a lot of mixed feelings, scandal, but also success. I hope you enjoyed this video, and remember to subscribe if you haven't done it yet, because in the next episode we are going to read another important romantic painting. Ciao!